Hello friends, welcome to Term Science. Today's topic is about syllabus overview of Thermal Engineering 2. Subject code is ME85 for Anniversity, Tamil Nadu. In this lecture, we will discuss the importance of Thermal Engineering for Mechanical Engineers, objective of this course, syllabus for each unit, outcomes after completion of the course, and textbooks that are available for this syllabus. Now we'll move on to the importance of thermal engineering. Thermal engineering is a subject that deals with systems or applications which is used to generate either power or refrigeration. We know that the importance of power and refrigeration in a modern world. Let's take for example boiler. Boiler is a device which used to generate steam. We know that steam can be generated with different pressure and different temperature. For a different pressure and different temperature, as a mechanical engineer, we have to design and manufacture a boiler. That will give thermal engineering. And one more example you can take, IC engines. For a given compression ratio, what will be the maximum efficiency that can be obtained from the engine? That will be given by thermal engineering. And also you can take one more example, refrigerator. In the given two different temperatures, indoor temperature, outdoor temperature, we can find out the maximum COP of the refrigerator. So these are the few very important of studying thermal engineering. Now we will move on to the objectives of this syllabus, that is ME8595. The first objective is to apply the thermodynamic concepts for nozzle, boiler, turbine and refrigerator, air conditioner. Nozzle is unit 1, boiler is unit 2, turbine is unit 3, whereas refrigeration and air conditioner is unit 5. And you can see here, nozzle, boiler, turbine, these three things are steam related. So for power generation. And whereas refrigerator and air conditioner is for refrigeration. Then what about unit 4, that is objective 2. To understand the concept of utilizing residual heat in thermal system. Which means how to use the waste heat. For example, you take boiler. The exhaust of the boiler will be around 190 degrees Celsius. Whereas atmospheric temperature 30 degrees Celsius. So we have 160 degrees Celsius is difference that can be used for other purpose. Like process industries, all those things. So that will be studying in unit 4, how to find out the additional heat loss and where we can use that heat applications. That will be seeing in your unit 4. These two are objective of this subject. Now we'll move on to the syllabus. The first unit is steam nozzle. In steam nozzle, we know nozzle is a device which is to convert pressure energy into kinetic energy. Nozzle will be in a varying cross-section area. In this, we will see types of nozzles and shape of nozzle. General nozzle. Nozzle can be used anywhere. In perfume bottle, cleaners, steam, power plant, all those places. And importantly, we will see here, flow of steam through the nozzle. That is an important topic in this unit. The second one, we will go for critical pressure ratio when we study conversion diversion nozzle. P2 divided by P1 or P3 divided by P2. Also, we will go into analyze what will be maximum mass flow rate with critical pressure ratio. Next one, effect of friction. The friction may be between the steam or steam and nozzle wall. So, what will be the changes occurs when there is a friction in the nozzle? And metastable flow. Steam is not expanded what we have expected due to the maybe friction or some other reason. That will be seeing in steam nozzle. The next unit is unit 2, boilers. Already we discussed, boiler is a device which generates the steam. So we will see types and comparison. We know water tube boiler, fire tube boiler. And in water tube boiler we have many sectors, in fire tube boiler we have many sectors. How these operates, that comparison we will discuss. and mounting and accessories. Very, very important. Mountings means how to control a boiler with instruments or components. Those things we will see, controllers. And accessories, how to improvise the efficiency of the boiler. That are the accessories we will be discussing in boiler. Next, fuels that are used for boilers. Solid, liquid, gas like coal, diesel or methane or propane, whatever it is. That thing we will see. Next, performance calculation and boiler trials. We calculate direct efficiency and indirect method. Both we will see in boiler unit. This unit is completely 70% is theory, 30% is problematic. Whereas unit 1 is 100% is problematic. We have one theory, metasable flow, that also is rare. The next unit is steam turbine. So we have seen steam nozzle, boiler, steam turbine. In this unit, we will study types of steam turbine, maybe impulse or reaction. Those difference we will see. Next, very, very important, we will draw the velocity diagram for steam turbine blade. And we will find out work burn and efficiency, how to optimize that one. Last thing, those things we will see in this unit. Next, multi-stage, more than one stage, how to do compounding like velocity, pressure, all these things, and how to control the speed, governing we will see. Next unit, 4, cogeneration and residual heat recovery. Cogeneration means we know one input, two output. So which means after the expansion of turbine, if you have high pressure and high temperature steam that can be used for process or other applications, that is cogeneration, where you generate power as well as you used for process industries. Residual heat recovery, we know we will be extracting heat from waste that can be used for other purpose. In this unit, we will see cogeneration principles, cycle analysis and application way that can be used, and source and utilization of the residual heat. We have to analyze sources of residual heat and how we can use that. To use that or to extract the heat, the devices that we have to use, like heat pipe, heat pump, recuperator, regenerator, all these things we will be studying in unit 4. The next unit is refrigeration and air conditioning. It's related to refrigeration part, where half of the unit will study refrigeration and half of the unit will be study air conditioning. In refrigeration, we will be seeing vapor compressor refrigeration system. If you are superheating, how it will be, subcooling, how it will be, and performance calculation. And theory part, air cycle and vapor absorption cycle, and also thermoelectric refrigeration. The next part, air conditioning. We will study about process, like room sensible heat factor, gross sensible heat factor, how to calculate the cooling loads, all we will be seeing in refrigeration. Next one is cooling towers. We know cooling tower is used for steam power plant. Cooling tower is nothing but is one of the heat exchanger. So types of cooling tower and concept we will be studying in unit 5. And you can see here the outcomes. First three units related to the power generation, steam power plant, nozzle, turbine, boiler. Fourth unit, how to improvise the steam power plant or refrigeration, which means we are extracting the heat from a device. And unit 5 is completely refrigeration. So as a mechanical engineer, we will come to know how to find out the performance of all these devices, how to optimize, how to improve the efficiency of these devices. That is outcomes of this subject. If you look at textbooks, there are so many textbooks are available for thermal engineering. I have mentioned few textbooks here. Kozanda Raman CP, Dom Kunduvar S, Dom Kunduvar AV, A course in thermal engineering. Mahesh M. Rathore, very good textbook. Aurora CP for refrigeration and air conditioning for unit 5 alone. And Balane PL for thermal engineering. Other than these four textbooks, we have R.K. Rajput thermal engineering. This is a very good textbook. You can go for it. If you have any doubts in syllabus, you can comment. I can give it to you. If you like this video, kindly share, like, and subscribe. Thank you.